You point Power BI to a folder of Excel files, expecting it to just work, but it gives you an error because each Excel file has a different sheet name. If you've already run into this, you know this is frustrating. If you haven't, this happens more often than you would think. For example, with monthly reports uploaded or sent to you by someone else. But there is a way to handle it cleanly, dynamically, and with no manual renaming. Let me show you. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. So let's look at the files that we have here. So we have different Excel files coming in. And again, the challenge is that the sheet name that we want to pull in is different. So 2022, and then we go in here, and this is 2023. So as you're going to see in Power BI, it is going to fail when we point to a folder. So let's go over to Power BI. By the way, you can get this file, and in fact, our whole treasure chest, by going to learnpowerbi.com/download to practice through as we go through these videos. All right, perfect. So let's step into the kitchen of Power BI. I'm going to click on the transform data button, and we're here. And I think I was trying to do something here. I'll delete that. Let's get started again. So I'm going to say new source and more, and I'm going to type in folder. And select folder from that list. I have the folder path, so I'm just going to paste that. Hit OK. Now, and make sure to click transform data. You do not want to combine yet. So we're going to hit transform data. And in here, it's picking up the Power BI file, which I had saved there. But that's an easy fix. We're going to go to extension and filter out the PBIX. And by the way, a tip here, from here, make sure to check, kind of glance the code here. Make sure it's generating the right code. So extension is XLSX. That's great. That's going to keep us focused on the Excel file. Now I'm going to keep the name column and content. So I'm going to select those two, right click, and say remove other columns. That's done. And now I'm going to click expand, this expand button on the content. And it asks me to select. I'm just going to select the first sheet, hit OK. And it's going to seem to work. So let's go back to, so you can see it's showing me this preview. It's created all these functions and everything seems to work, right? So here it's doing it and I'm like, yep, source filtered, invoked custom function. But I'm just going to hit close and apply and show you what you have probably already experienced. And that's why you're watching this video, or you're going to be experiencing. So yeah, and the first time I got it, I'm like, what is this? And sometimes Microsoft errors are very helpful and they're like, yep, you know, yo, I know what to fix. But in this case, it had me scratching my head a little bit. So the key didn't match any rows in the table. So let's go back to transform data and maybe I'll show you how I kind of clued into it. So if you do run into an error like this, you can try a few things. For one, you can go in here and I can click on the table icon right here and say keep error rows and keep errors. And what that's gonna do is just gonna filter down to only the error rows. So that's what I tried. Now this wasn't very helpful. Now it gave me the same thing. The key didn't match any rows in the table, but you know, it was like 2022 kind table. I'm like, huh, okay. So that's how I figured out where the problem might be. And of course, if you are used to getting files from a folder, you're very used to seeing these group of queries that are created automatically by Power BI, the transform file from download. And this is actually a very sophisticated and very smart design on Power BI's team. Kudos to that. I don't remember who built that feature, who was the project manager or main lead for that, but brilliantly done. And what it does is it has a function, right? It has this function which is being called by your step. And when it says invoke custom function, that is exactly the function that is being called. And you can see that in the formula bar over here, right? So that, but Power BI is not gonna let you edit that function directly because rightly so, it doesn't trust most of us to be able to edit a function because that's gonna be hard M code. So if you click on the advanced editor, it's gonna warn you. And I generally heed that warning. I'm like, yep, I'm not gonna edit it. But the good news is it has given you this mirror query which mirrors the FX, right? So it mirrors that one. So instead of having to go into the M code and edit that function, like if you step into the M code, it doesn't look so scary now. But yeah, I mean, I would rather use the ribbon. So that's all we have to do to fix this. So we come to the transform sample file and notice the navigation step, right? So what it does is it teaches Power BI how to process each file. That's what the function is. And then in our query, it says, yep, I have a list of files and I'm going to try to process each of these files using these steps. Does that make sense, right? So now if we go back here, we can figure out, we can finally put the pieces together. So why is it not working? Because if you look at the steps, it's saying connect to the file and then navigate to a table called 2022. Well, that doesn't work for the 2023 file. That's easy though. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go back here and you can actually do a few steps here. So for one, again, based on if you're going to a sheet or a table, I would filter down to that sheet. And in this case, I only have one sheet, but if you have multiple, you're going to have to come up with a logic to filter down or sort or something to that sheet, right? Generally, though, what I do is I come back here, and in this, I'm going to edit it and remove this whole block, right? So I remove this whole thing, and then I'm just going to type in 0 in there. Now, I'll explain to you what that's doing. So what that 0 is doing, it's saying that, you know what, just give me the first one. That's what it's doing. So in this case, that's what I want. That's all I want. But again, your case might be slightly different based on what your files are. But whatever that logic is, you should be able to code it in here. So now we got the first file and the rest, it added automatic step. Yes, I'm going to say that the automatic change type step I almost always delete, but I'm going to leave it there for now. And I'm just going to practice good documentation and I'm going to rename this step. So instead of 2022 table, I'm just going to say right click rename and you know, I'll just say get first sheet. There we go. And now if we go back here, now we can test here, so we can say keep errors. And that's empty and that's great. And now let's load that table and see all of our files come in 2022, 23, 24 in this case. So that is loaded. We go to the data tab, download, and let's see the order date ascending. So it starts in 2022, descending 2024. So we have all the files coming in from this folder, even though they had different sheet names. Hey, for more tips and tricks in Power BI, make sure to follow me on LinkedIn and YouTube. But if you're looking for a structured training program with community and support, check out my website, learnpowerbi.com. See you in the next one. Take care and power on.